here at church. Now, for those of you that don't know anything about different streams of churches, they believe in the gifts of healing, but them vineyard churches, I mean, they idea of worship, you may get a banjo and a tambourine, and they be in. I mean, all the way. They will break for 20 minutes, go get coffee, and come back like there's nothing happening. She is the only black woman in this particular service. Unbeknownst to Vivian, a prophet of God who is not looking for a seat, a spot, a microphone, or an invitation to a prayer breakfast, she's at that church. And while she's at church, she sees this Caucasian gentleman. Unbeknownst to her, this gentleman is not saved, not a believer, doesn't know God. His wife says, "Why don't you come with me to my church tomorrow?" Two portions to the story. His wife is convincing him, go to church. God, through a member or a friend of Vivian, says, go to church. On the same day at the same hour. After worship, Vivian is sitting in the back of the church. This man comes not looking like he knows much. And when they got up and said, "I want you to go and hug your neighbor," the last chapter of this book says the moral of the story. The first chapter says, as I went to church, extremely doubtful about why I was here, what was going on with me and my business, extremely discouraged, this black lady, beelines, is the exact word he used, turns from me and everybody else, finds me and runs up on me and says, "I have a word for you." Come on, say, "Become the prophets." Open your mouth, say, "Become the prophets." And so it's walk back, looks at this lady, like, I've heard stuff like this before, okay, I don't know what you're talking about, but you mean you got a word. Vivian proceeds to look at him and says, "You are really good at math, and you have some type of formula in your brain that you've been trying to figure out for years." He says in parentheses in this book, "I was extremely frightened at this point because there are thousands of people in here, and how does this lady know I'm working on the 80-20 sales and marketing thing that I cannot crack?" He says, then Vivian looks at me and says to me, "Not only are you going to crack it, and not only is it going to prosper you, but God's going to make it go around the world." He says he is quivering in his knees. He is shaken. He don't know God. He don't know church. But this black lady that came up on him talking about, "I have a word." He then says that Vivian turns around, makes her way to her seat, and turns around like Isaiah did to Hezekiah. And before she could get to her seat, she said, "One more thing. You God is going to bless you because you want to sow into missions." He begins to weep uncontrollably because although he is not a believer, what Vivian does not know is that there is a family in Mozambique that he has been sponsoring for the last several years that he now is trying to decide if he can get money from this formula to feed. Vivian does not know what she's talking about, but the spirit of prophecy in her has the ability to reach the details of this man. So she leaves, never sees the man again. 10 years later, Vivian is sitting at her job, gets a phone call. "Hi, this is Vivian calling." She says, "No, I'm not Vivian Hearn. I understand that, okay. Do you know Prayer Marshall?" "No, ma'am, I've never heard of him before." "You haven't seen him on the news?" "No, ma'am, I haven't before." "Go ahead and Google him. Doesn't look familiar, I don't know." "Well, he's dedicated a book to you that is now a New York Times bestseller. And he talks a whole story about you at the last chapter."
"Oh my God."
She says, "Oh, I think I vaguely remember telling somebody something about a math problem. But maybe that's not him." She said, "Oh, no. Trust me, it's him. This powerful multimillionaire that got on LinkedIn, Google, to try to find this black lady that prophesied to him about what's now making him millions of dollars. He finds her at her job, calls her, and the secretary says, go ahead and give him a call." Vivian says, "No, I'm not calling this man." She said, "No, trust me, give him a call." Vivian calls him and says, "Hi, this is Vivian Hearn." "Vivian, is that you?" "Come on, sir, give him a call." "Is that you?"
"Yes, it's me."
"Oh, this is what he says to her. He says, I want you to pack your bags. To come to this dinner, and I'm going to invite you here. Of course, I'm going to pay for you, but I want None of these business people know her, but Robert Hearns is telling this story. Perry Marshall is telling this story. And he tells about the power of his prophetic word. He is now saved. He is now a multi-millionaire. He is now somebody who finances missions project, and he ain't done. Watch me. So he gives his story to these business people. And all of them are like, oh my God, where is this lady? He then says, Vivian, when you come up front, they establish a line. They would pay $19,000 to come and get a word from a black lady who yesterday didn't even know she prophesied. The prophetic word has power to be catapulted around the world. And that fact that reached New York Times bestseller.